This is the fourth generation Porsche 911 Cabrio. So with every Cabrio, and with every Porsche for that matter, the challenge is to make them lighter, faster, and of course, look great. Now, with any convertible, the challenge is also to keep the overall shape of its coupe counterpart. I think Porsche has done a great job of that. Before we get into the top, let's talk about the windscreen because it is part of the top. In the past, Porsche's had a separate piece that you've had to store somewhere and kind of physically put into the back of the car. No longer. Now we have an automatic button. You just push a button and the windscreen comes right up. So what we have here is a three-panel magnesium roof, and it's all inside an aluminum frame. It folds kind of like a Z shape into the back, goes away real nice and light. Now, overall, the car weighs more than the coupe, but a lot less than the outgoing Cabriolet. The convertible roof can be operated at speeds up to 30 miles per hour and just takes 13 seconds to raise or lower. Some of you may wonder, why doesn't Porsche just put a metal top, kind of like Mercedes did with the SL? Well, the obvious answer is weight. But here's another answer you didn't know, is that most people who own convertibles want a cloth top because they want the world to know, hey, I'm driving a convertible. As you can see, there's no question about this car. Now, Porsche has addressed the traditional problems with these cloth tops. For example, sound and thermal insulation has been a real problem in the past. No longer. These are extremely high-tech magnesium roofs, and I gotta tell you, driving this car, even at really high speeds, you just don't really feel you're driving a convertible. Furthermore, the driving dynamics are outstanding. It's probably just a marginal difference from the coupe, and that's a tremendous coup for the engineers at Porsche. Okay, enough about the car. Yes, it's a Porsche 911S. It's beautiful, it starts at $108,000. Of course, you have a 400 horsepower, 325 pound-feet torque, 3.8 liter horizontally opposed six-cylinder engine. Yes, it's fast, 0 to 64.5 seconds, about 0.2 seconds slower than the coupe counterpart. But this thing is just beautiful, it's fast, and of course you got some major options like ceramic brakes, $8,500. If you're gonna take this car on the track, which you should, because over 10% of Porsche owners do, then you need ceramic brakes. These things are awesome. Some of the other options, this car actually has a 7-speed, does not have the PDK. 7-speed manual. It's the only car in the world that has that. It's a lot of fun to drive, very engaging. Not quite as quick as the PDK, but certainly a lot more fun. All right, well, enough talking about the 911S Cabrio. Let's get to some driving. So as quiet as the 911 Cabrio is from wind noise, it still lets you hear the motor and the exhaust, and of course, that's what you want when you're driving a car like this. Now, some Porsche purists complain about the electromagnetic steering. And the reason Porsche did that is because it reduces weight. It also makes the vehicle more fuel efficient. Hard to believe you can get a 400 horsepower sports car like the Porsche 911 and still get 19 miles to the gallon city, 27 on the highway. Now, this is the S model. They also make a base model, which has 350 horsepower. And that one is kind of intriguing because when you look at that vehicle, 350 horsepower versus 315 for the Boxster S, the same 0 to 60 times 4.8 seconds, but a price difference of about $30,000, now you really start to kind of scratch your head because I really like the Boxster S. It's a very light car and I think it looks good and just makes a lot of sense. But for people who are not on the budget, you got to go with the 911. So what's the bottom line on the Porsche 911S Cabrio? Well, here it is. You've got options. For example, Mercedes SL, maybe even the Audi R8 Spider with the V8. How about cars like the Aston Martin and the Maserati? All great cars, but you know what? None of them really are as light as this car or have the heritage of this car. You're talking about over 40 years of Porsche 911 experience. This car is a true sports car and it's really the best of both worlds. So guess what? You want a Porsche 911. Your wife, your girlfriend, she wants a convertible. With this car, you can have it all.